Good evening. I'm Captain Jason Baldhorst, and I welcome you to the Newport News Police Department's annual award ceremony. Welcome to distinguished visitors, award recipients, and police personnel. I'd also like to introduce a few individuals. Mayor McKinley Price, Assistant City Manager Alan Archer, Retired Chief of Police Bill Corvello, former Mayor Joe Frank, and Miss Amanda Roten, and also Anna Whalen, President of the Citizens Police Academy Alumni Association. Chaplain Chaney, please come forward for the invocation.
Good evening. Let us bow our heads before God, please. Dear God, we thank you for this opportunity to gather and to celebrate the sworn officers, civilian employees, civilian volunteers, and quick-thinking, civic-minded citizens who are to be honored here tonight. We ask your guidance and blessing upon those individuals who choose the difficult and dangerous responsibility of protecting the citizens and this community of Newport News. We thank you for the opportunity and privilege you have given us all to be responsible leaders and the privilege of serving the needy, protecting the vulnerable, and helping to transform lives here in Newport News. Amen.
All right, it is my pleasure now to introduce Chief Richard Myers.
Good evening. I can't think of a better way to start Police Week than to celebrate the outstanding accomplishments of our men and women. Welcome to everyone here tonight. This is a great crowd, and we're excited to honor so many folks. I do want to repeat the acknowledgement of Captain Baldhorst in welcoming. Certainly want to welcome our mayor, McKinley Price. I've said this many times. He's probably sick of hearing me say it, but I think it's so symbolic and so important to men and women who serve the community in the capacity that we all do, to know that our top elected leaders support us and what we do. And by the mayor's participation tonight, by being here, he's sending that message as he usually does. Almost always we see him at all kinds of department events. So, Mayor, you have our gratitude. Thank you. Alan Archer was introduced. Alan is actually the acting city manager this week. Even though we have a brand new city manager, she had a long planned and long paid for vacation, and she and her husband are enjoying that. And so I know, Alan, when you wear about five hats like you are this week, it's a challenge. So thank you so much for being here. It's always a pleasure, and we'll get to see him again tomorrow night as part of our memorial service, to include and welcome retired Chief Corvello. In my time here, he's become a great friend and a mentor, and you're always welcome anytime any of us are gathered. So thank you for being here. Finally, I just want to acknowledge and thank my executive team who are all here, starting with Ms. Lillian Taylor, someone that some of you may not recognize with his scraggly beard, Assistant Chief Mike Grinstead. Where did he go? He's hiding out. There he is with his brand new knee joining us. Glad to have you here, Mike. And Assistant Chief Stacy Kelly and Assistant Chief Joe Moore also. Thank you all for your daily support and help in leading this great organization. I especially want to thank the Newport News Police Foundation tonight for their financial support that makes this entire evening possible. You don't get the Marriott for nothing. And we're here in this beautiful room and get to enjoy some wonderful refreshments afterwards, thanks to the financial support of the foundation. And of course, joining us tonight is the foundation president, former Mayor Jill Frank, and their executive director, Amanda Roten. Thank you both for your continued support. Finally, I just want to express what an honor it is for me personally to serve with you as your chief. These are certainly tough times in policing. And I can't think of another group of cops and support staff that I'd rather be shoulder to shoulder with than you all. Let's take some time tonight to reflect on the blessings that we have in our agency, the quality training, the great men and women we work with every day, and despite what the popular media sometimes portrays, the strong support that we enjoy from our community. We are truly blessed. And in just a few minutes, you'll hear how those blessings manifest in acts of courage, compassion, and life-saving efforts. Thank you all, and again, welcome.
Good evening. I'm Lieutenant Barefoot, and to my right is Lieutenant Creswell. We are honored to be part of this service. We gather this evening to recognize those sworn and civilian employees of the Newport News Police Department, individuals from other agencies and civilians, for the numerous outstanding acts. We will now begin the award ceremony. Each of the men and women you will see tonight deserve this recognition as they perform their duties in an excellent manner. Unfortunately, several award recipients are unable to join us this evening. However, they are listed in your programs. As your name is read, please join the chief on stage and remain on stage until all the names in the group have been read and photographs are taken. Each quarter, the department recognizes employees for outstanding performance. The 2016 quarterly award recipients listed in the program are recognized at the precinct level. In addition, those officers who have removed five or more weapons from the streets in 2016 are listed in the program and are recognized at the precinct division level. We congratulate all quarterly award and Chief's Award for weapon recovery recipients. We would like to now recognize those employees who have dedicated 25 years of service to the department. Master Police Detective Darlene Best, and Master Police Officer Rodney Howard. Master Police Detective Best and Master Police Officer Howard, thank you for your devoted and stellar service to the department and the community.
The Citizen Service Award is presented to a citizen for an extreme act of bravery while assisting the police department or one of its employees, or rendering help to an officer for a police department employee, or providing significant assistance in solving a case or service to law enforcement. Ms. Sherry Pack will be receiving the Citizens Service Award. Please come up. On July 1st, 2016, Ms. Peck observed a black four-door car that didn't look familiar for automobiles in the neighborhood cul-de-sac on Don Terrace. Ms. Peck photographed the automobile and license plate. The photographs included a male operating the vehicle. Shortly afterwards, the police department received a telephone call reporting a male who was wearing gloves had exited a black Acura sedan, jumped the fence, and went to the rear of a home located on Don Terrace. Ms. Peck's quick thinking and actions led to the arrest of the burglary suspect, who was still in the home upon the police officer's arrival. During the interview with the detectives, the suspect admitted to have forcibly entered the residence and removed money from a cabinet drawer. The detectives ultimately charged the suspect with burglary and grand larceny. Thank you, Ms. Peck. Mr. William Taylor and Mr. Leon Lovings Jr. will also be receiving Citizen Service Awards. Please come forward. On September 3rd, 2016, a victim filed a burglary report with our department. The victim is a resident of Christopher Crossing's apartment complex. The victim reported televisions and an Xbox gaming system were taken during the burglary. As employees of the apartment complex, you were made aware of the burglary and items taken from the residence. Later during the week, the two of you entered an apartment to check for water leaks. Upon entry, you observed a television and Xbox in the living room. You contacted the police department and gave the information to an officer. Further investigation revealed that the property belonged to the victim and the suspect was arrested. Thank you.
The Outstanding Contribution to Law Enforcement Award is awarded to civilian employees and employees of other law enforcement agencies who have throughout the year exhibited exemplary performance or for a particular act during the year. This year's recipients of the Outstanding Contribution to Law Enforcement Award are members of AT&T, FBI, and the Virginia Beach Police Department. Senior Investigator William Long Jr., Sergeant Mark Leno, Special Agent Jason Collins, and Detective Michael Lose. On February 9, 2016, at AT&T Wireless Cell Phone Store became a victim of a business robbery. The store located at the Tech Center in Newport News was robbed of 143 iPhones and approximately $3,000 from the safe. One suspect was armed with a high-powered assault rifle and the other with a semi-automatic handgun. The suspect zip-tied the clerk's hands and fled the scene, operating a dark gray or silver Audi. On February 25, 2016, and again on April 7, 2016, AT&T wireless cell phone stores located in Virginia Beach became victims of this robbery series. Through investigative techniques, intelligence gathering, and your commitment to law enforcement, the suspects confessed to the AT&T wireless store robberies in Newport News and Virginia Beach. You are to be commended. Thank you. Volunteers Marie Carter, Joyce Dixon, Kathleen Martin, Cynthia Perkins, Chaplain Donald Reed, and Anna Whalen will also be receiving the Outstanding Contribution to Law Enforcement Award. Volunteers Marie Carter, your volunteer time is essential to the daily functions of the recruiting unit. You have been performing the crucial task of processing police recruit applicants through the standard oral process and candidate profile summary each week. These mandatory elements of the application process are time-consuming and would have a negative impact on the productivity of the recruiting unit staff were it not for your efforts. Thank you for your continued support. Police aide Gina Rogers will also be receiving the Outstanding Contribution to Law Enforcement Award. In February 2016, you went above and beyond the call of duty and became a field training officer for the first time for a newly hired police cadet program. You made sure everything in the training manual was taught, explained, and documented. The police cadet program is a new program, and you were instrumental in writing the new policies for training the cadets prior to their release to independent patrol. You are a general instructor who also participates in group tasks with the Newport News Police Department's recruiting division, including the physical agility tests, career fairs, and conducting background checks for new hires. You participate in the oral review board process, interviewing applicants as well. Thank you for what you do. We have one more Outstanding Contribution to Law Enforcement Award recipient, but we will include her with the other personnel receiving recognition for the same event.
The Outstanding Police Performance Certificate is awarded to Newport News sworn officers who have throughout the year exhibited exemplary performance or for a particular act during the year. The following personnel will be receiving the Outstanding Police Performance Award. Officer Nicholas Basso-Bilbasso, Officer Heather Fronenberg, Officer Scannarella Lasose, and Officer Wynn Stewart. On July 1st, 2016, the police department received a telephone call from an anonymous caller stating they had seen a male wearing gloves exit a black Acura sedan, jump a fence, and go to the rear of a home located on Don Terrace. A quick response by our officers led to the arrest of the burglary suspect, who was still in the house upon the officer's arrival, but attempted to flee upon hearing the arrival of officers. During the interview with detectives, the suspect admitted to have forcibly entered the residence and removed money from a cabinet drawer. The suspect was ultimately charged with burglary and grand larceny. Thank you, officers. Master Police Officer Wright will also be receiving the Outstanding Police Performance Award. On October 25, 2016, MPO Wright responded to a report of a missing Alzheimer's patient. He, along with MPO Newcomb, found the missing 87-year-old man, but while interviewing his wife, it became apparent that she could not keep up with her husband's progressing disease. MPO Wright and Newcomb spent several hours working with his wife, the apartment manager, and the Newport News Sheriff's Office Project Lifesaver Unit. Additionally, they purchased and paid for door chimes that would activate when the husband tried to leave the apartment without his wife's knowledge. This level of compassion is above and beyond the expectation of a law enforcement officer. Thank you, MPO Wright.
Sergeant Scott Hussle, Master Police Officer Jonathan Hatton, Master Police Officer Lewis Proper, Officer Eric Brown, Officer Molly Clark, and Officer Eduardo Ruiz will also be receiving the Outstanding Police Performance Award, and Senior Forensic Technician Sandy Cleary will be receiving the Outstanding Contribution to Law Enforcement Award. Please come up. On August 18, 2016, you were part of a team effort that successfully identified and apprehended a violent offender from our community. The suspect shot a female and then injured another person when he shot the window out of the vehicle in which the victim was sitting. The team's efforts during the incident, the initial observations of the offender shooting, the offender fleeing from officers, setting up a perimeter, apprehension of the offender, processing of the scene, and working together cohesively allowed the incident to end without further harm to citizens, Newport News Police Department personnel, or the offender. Thank you. Sergeant Charles Hauser, Detective John Hunt, Officer Angston, and Officer Allison Sprinkle will also be receiving the Outstanding Police Performance Award. On August 28, 2016, you were part of a team effort that obtained a search warrant and successfully identified a marijuana growing operation. The search resulted in locating a pound of dried and drying marijuana, 8 marijuana plants, and 6 firearms. Additionally, through the partnership developed between patrol officers and narcotics detectives, 2 suspects were arrested without a major incident. The team efforts during this incident, the initial observations of a male subject refusing medical treatment, detecting the odor of marijuana in the residence, obtaining a search warrant for the residence, maintaining security of detained residents, collecting the evidence, and interrogating the residents is a textbook example of a patrol response to the narcotics detectives and the actions you took. Thank you.
A recipient of the Chief's Award is chosen solely by Chief Myers. This special coin of recognition is awarded as an expression of gratitude for exemplary performance or for a particular act during the year. The following officers are the top arresting officers for DUIs for 2016. Officer Corey Sadler, Officer Jacqueline Merriman, and Officer Daniel Akaratovic. You are all to be commended. Thank you. The Life-Saving Rescue Medal is awarded to any employee who takes reasonable action in an attempt to save a human life where the recipient was not placed in personal danger. Detective John Hunt and Officer Kevin Millett are receiving the Life-Saving Rescue Awards for their actions. On January 5, 2016, Detective Hunt and Officer Millett were dispatched to a suicidal subject. His probation officer called to report that Mr. Johnson was attempting suicide. Information was provided that Mr. Johnson had tried to hang himself and that he had a knife. Detective Hunt called the girlfriend and she informed him that she had taken the knife away from him, but he was attempting to hang himself. When Detective Hunt and Officer Millett arrived, the front door was slightly ajar. A female yelled for them to come in and help. They entered in the residence in the rear bedroom observed a female trying to lift Mr. Johnson, who was hanging by a belt from the ceiling. As Officer Millett lifted Mr. Johnson to relieve the tension, Detective Hunt was able to retrieve his knife and cut the belt. If not for your quick actions, Mr. Johnson may have succeeded in the taking of his own life. Thank you.
Officer Brandon Quirros would have been receiving the Life-Saving Rescue Award. However, he's on a late arrest. He will not be joining us tonight. Officer Mark Hillman will also be receiving the Life-Saving Rescue Award. On December 24, 2016, you were dispatched to North Trellis Court in reference to a subject who had possibly overdosed. The first officer to arrive, you located the unresponsive male and immediately began CPR. You were able to resuscitate the subject prior to the arrival of the medical unit. Members of the medic unit complimented you and confirmed that your actions had saved the gentleman's life. Your quick action had an immediate impact on this man's life and has provided his family with his continued presence in their lives. Thank you.
The Bronze Medal of Valor is awarded when an officer performs a courageous act beyond what is normally expected of a dedicated officer in a similar situation. The officer's actions are sound and appropriate, and through his own actions or those of others is exposed to an unusually high level of damage, and the danger is such that death or serious injury is realistic possibility. MPO Jamie Acree is receiving the Bronze Medal of Valor for her actions. On January 14, 2016, units were dispatched to a vehicle crash. Dispatch further advised that there was a subject at the scene with a gun and that shots had been fired. When the officers arrived, they observed inside one of the vehicles two subjects that had been shot and killed. The subject that had committed the shooting ran down the street. The first officer on the scene advised what the suspect was wearing and the direction to travel. You and Sergeant Bartley arrived in the area towards which the suspect was running and were in the process of setting up a perimeter when you observed the suspect. It appeared the suspect discharged his weapon in an attempt to gain entry into an apartment. Once you observed the weapon and he was not following your commands, you both discharged your weapons at the suspect. After the suspect was secured, two weapons were recovered in his immediate area. The decision made by you and Sergeant Bartley successfully secured the scene for the safety of nearby residents. Thank you for your actions. MPO Steve Pennington will also be receiving the Bronze Medal of Valor. On August 17, 2016, while arriving home from a 10-hour shift, you heard a loud explosion, saw a bright flash of light, and observed that the power went out in the neighborhood. You immediately called dispatch and went out into the neighborhood to investigate. Two blocks away, you discovered a tree had fallen in the road. As you got closer, a small explosion went off in the nearby tree line, which appeared to ignite a fire. What you did not know was that the fallen tree had ruptured a natural gas line under the roadway. As you were assessing the situation, you heard a loud pop behind a residence on Eastwood Drive and found flames shooting from the gas meter. You immediately ran to the front door and found the resident returning to the inside of the house. You entered the smoke-filled house and pulled the resident out the front door. You are to be commended for your actions. Thank you.
Dispatcher of the Year is presented to Ms. Brooke Tidwell. You were instrumental in developing, implementing, and instructing the Communication Division's first Communications Fire Academy. During this time, you also assumed the role of Communications Training Officer and assisted with the training of newly hired dispatchers. As a CTO, you took initiative by creating your own daily observation report to allow your trainees to stay abreast of their daily work performance and taking the initiative to share your knowledge, skills, and abilities to benefit less experienced coworkers. You are well respected and you perform your work to the highest degree of professional excellence. The continuous display of professionalism sheds a positive light on our organization, most notably the exceptional level of customer service that you provide, not only to the citizens of Newport News, but also the personnel of all the public safety agencies that we serve. Thank you. Officer of the Year is presented to Detective Catherine Walczak. Last year, you were able to complete your investigation regarding a solicitation for murder case involving two victims. During your interview of the suspect, he acknowledged to you he was the author of a letter ordering the solicitations. For that, you were able to seek direct indictments. During this time, you were also able to assist another detective with the documentation of gang members from a specific sect. This was a very consuming task and required you to pore over numerous files and binders, and in some instances, seek your own or additional information in order to obtain the required documentation. This huge task assisted with the successful prosecution of several gang members. The outstanding work you have accomplished shows your attention to detail and willingness to accept new challenges. Thank you.
Supervisor of the Year is presented to Valerie Atkinson. In addition to performing your daily responsibilities as a training coordinator in the Communications Division, you took the time to serve as a primary training officer, affording that employee all opportunities to succeed and achieve full certification. You are a team player, and you regularly volunteer your personal time to work long hours due to staff shortages, ensuring other team members receive vacation time and scheduled days off. Additionally, your assistance in reviewing, gathering, and organizing all required paperwork for the review conducted by the Commission of Accreditation for Law Enforcement Agencies, also known as CALEA, ensured the Communications Division maintained national accreditation, which is not an easy task. You also maintain certification and a professional relationship with the National Center for Missing and Exploited Children, ensuring cases are handled correctly and in a timely manner. These accomplishments, along with many others not mentioned, reflect great credit on yourself and your dedication to the City of Newport News and its citizens. Thank you.
The following individuals have been chosen to receive the Problem Solving of the Year Award. Sergeant Richard Fish, Master Police Detective Thomas Comer, Master Police Detective Galen Dosky, Master Police Detective Joshua Calhoun, Master Police Detective Ryan Norris, Master Police Detective Jeffrey Turlington, Detective Thomas Spence, Crime Analyst Jennifer Connor, Crime Analyst Jennifer Johnston. Members of the Organized Crime Division, Mid-Level Narcotics Unit, and members of the Crime Analyst Group have been responsible for investigating all heroin, fentanyl, and heroin-fentanyl-related overdoses and deaths in the City of Newport News. Heroin availability is increasing in areas throughout the nation as used by a larger number of people. With that comes an increase in investigative challenges and strategies that this group had to adapt to and overcome as there is no longer a typical user. The members of this investigative group have consistently demonstrated their commitment to the community they serve by showing compassion and empathy for the victims, family members of victims, and witnesses throughout their investigative processes. During the period of January 1st, 2016 to December 31st, 2016, this team was responsible for investigating over 107 heroin, fentanyl, and heroin-fentanyl-related overdoses, with 22 of those having resulted in a death. Even through their number one goal was to reduce crime and the fear of crime in our city, each member of this investigative team recognizes the importance of accomplishing that goal by strengthening partnerships with not only our federal partners, but their community. One example of their tireless efforts is when this team began investigating a group of individuals distributing large quantities of heroin and cocaine in the City of Newport News and elsewhere in the Eastern District of Virginia. As a part of their investigative strategy, the team began the exhaustive task of identifying the source of the heroin supply. That strategy included, but was not limited to, locating and identifying cooperating witnesses, locating and interviewing overdose victims associated with the same source of supply, utilizing confidential sources of information, and partnering with federal resources, the Drug Enforcement Administrator, DEA. During that investigation, a subject was identified as the main supplier of the drug trafficking organization, who was also found to have been the source of an amount of heroin causing the overdose and near death of an individual in our city. After extensive investigative efforts by this team, their hard work ultimately led to multiple federal indictments being obtained for all members of the drug trafficking organization to include conspiracy to distribute and possess with intent to distribute 1 kilogram or more of heroin, and use of a communication device to facilitate drug trafficking. Most importantly, the identified supplier was charged with and pleaded guilty to distribution of heroin resulting in serious bodily injury for the overdose and near death of an individual in our city. This possibly being the first time this section of the federal crime criminal code has been charged and successfully prosecuted in the Eastern District of Virginia. Thank you.
Individuals have been chosen to receive the Team Effort of the Year Award. Master Police Detective James Carden, Detective Joseph Carucci, and Detective Michael Call. As a member of the Peninsula Safe Streets Task Force and DEA Task Force, you were assigned to investigate a hybrid criminal street gang plaguing the Hampton Roads area. During the course of this lengthy investigation, the team began to dismantle the drug trafficking side of the enterprise. Eventually, a series of indictments were issued, ranging from street-level deals all the way up to the money couriers who paid the Mexican suppliers in California. Most of the individuals involved in the drug enterprise pleaded guilty, agreeing to provide information and cooperation in the prosecution of additional gang members who were involved in violent offenses, including those committing robbery, shooting, and multiple murders. After being charged with the act of violence, several of these members realized the overwhelming amount of evidence against them and ultimately pleaded guilty, agreeing to cooperate with the prosecution of their co-conspirators. One gang member, who eventually stood trial for his role as a shooter in 3 murders in which other gang members testified, was found guilty and sentenced to life in prison. In 2015, 6 members and associates of the gang were charged for their roles in 5 murders and numerous shootings. Prior to the trial, 3 of the members pleaded guilty and agreed to cooperate in the prosecution of the remaining defendants. This investigation, which began over 6 years ago, finally came to an end when the trial of the last 3 members began in June 2016. Thank you.
The George C. Austin Jr. Leadership Award is presented to a Newport News Police Department employee whose positive character, heart, and work ethic enables them to be a leader not only among their peers, but also in their community. This year's recipient is Master Police Detective Trevor Buchanan. You are currently assigned to the Criminal Investigations Division's Intelligence Unit. In addition to your assigned tasks and daily duties, you have committed to becoming the Newport News Police Department's subject matter expert concerning cell phone investigations. Early in 2016, the unit lost that skill set through a promotion, and you were tasked with assuming the specialty with very little knowledge or experience. You immersed yourself in the subject and spent countless hours learning as much as you could. Through this process, you became very familiar with a very highly technical process of cell phone exploitation. In addition to learning things on your own, you have completed over 100 hours of formal training specific to this specialty. Due to your knowledge and effort, you have become a tremendous asset to the Newport News Commonwealth Attorney's Office, routinely being called upon to review records that have been obtained and filed away, simply because the investigators did not know how to analyze the records for investigative value. Additionally, this led to conducting an informal class to teach exactly what the investigators should be looking for within these records. Currently, you are in the process of rolling out a cell phone investigation software program that will allow investigators to conduct their own cell phone exploitation as it pertains to their individual cases. This should result in better and quicker results for cases that involve cell phone records. By collecting phone numbers, obtaining search warrants, and analyzing records, your expertise resulted in 2 suspects wanted for a homicide being apprehended. One was taken in custody in Hampton, Virginia, with the assistance of the U.S. Marshals Service. The second was taken into custody in Atlanta, Georgia. Your efforts in this case were paramount in the safe apprehension of two very violent offenders, with work continuing to this day for the third suspect in this homicide. As a distinguished member of the department's tactical operations unit, you have been assigned as a sniper and have held that position for approximately 4 years. Within the last year, you submitted a 13-page proposal to update and improve the existing sniper program for the city of Newport News. You have also obtained approval to seek the American Sniper Association accreditation for our agency. This brings a certain level of skills as well as a verification that those skill sets are being adhered to and maintained. Through this effort, teams in Hampton, York County, Portsmouth, Virginia Beach, and Gloucester County are looking at improving their department's programs at varying degrees. Over the last year, you resourced and coordinated the first regional sniper exercise in the area. While maintaining your primary duties, you coordinated, resourced, and developed a realistic scenario that included movement techniques, cover and concealment, communication practices, and intelligence capturing. Along with Newport News, four other jurisdictions participated in this exercise, and all involved agreed that the benefits of this training were so substantial that this effort will be enlarged and held periodically throughout the region. Even though you are not in the public eye, representing our department with a badge and uniform, it should be understood that you have put your heart and soul in these efforts, drastically impacting the community that we all serve. Your efforts have directly contributed to the apprehension of very violent criminals, as well as better training and enhanced capabilities of very specialized police officers, officers who have very high expectations of being able to deploy and successfully accomplish their individual missions for the betterment of the agency and the community it serves. Thank you.
The William F. Corvella Leadership Award is presented to a Newport News Police Department employee whose activities have served to make that employee a community role model and whose generous community spirit and sharing efforts have improved the quality of life for Newport News. Chief Corvella, would you please join Chief Myers on the platform to present this award? This year's recipient of the Corvella Award is Master Police Detective Eric Mizell. You are a 9-year veteran of the Newport News Police Department and are currently assigned to the Major Crimes Division Special Victims Unit, where you investigate missing and runaway persons. When you were assigned to the Special Victims Unit, you were tasked with a monumental undertaking, managing the 500-plus caseload, make phone calls, and complete the necessary administrative work related to the many incidents you are now responsible for managing. In reality, your mission was more complex. The need to find a way to identify at-risk youths, connect their families to the appropriate services offered by various departments throughout the city of Newport News, and reduce the number of juvenile runaways within our city. You began the slow process of networking and learning the roles of multiple outside agencies and departments such as Human Services, Juvenile Intake, the Newport News Circuit Courts, the Newport News Court Systems, Newport News Youth and Gang Violence Preventative Initiative, law enforcement, and most of the families of the at-risk youth. You brought together leaders from each government agency and department to facilitate the sharing of information with each group. The success of this team approach to addressing at-risk youth can be credited to your steadfast efforts to unite appropriate attention and services to the families in need. Well after the juveniles have returned home or services have been rendered, families often call you to ask for advice and stay connected in situations that leave them confused about how to parent while their youth risk entry into criminal behavior. You are also tasked with the investigation and recovery of missing persons. During these investigations, you have connected with the family members reporting their loved ones missing. You have been the liaison with countless law enforcement agencies from across the United States and civilian advocate groups. One such case left you searching a local landfill for a week, attempting to locate the remains of a missing woman in order to bring closure to her family. You are to be commended for your efforts. Thank you.
Let's give a round of applause to all award recipients. Believe it or not, this concludes our ceremony. We would be honored if you would join us for a reception just outside the Grand Ballroom after Chaplain Brown delivers the benediction.
I like him. Dear God, we ask your blessing upon the Newport News Police Department and all the employees, both sworn and civilian, as well as our citizen partners. Give us all strength, courage, and compassion necessary to protect and serve our diverse community. Protect us from assaults from both within and without. Help and guide us as we go out into the world to serve you with honesty, integrity, and humility. And watch over us as we reassume the duties of protectors and guardians of this city. Amen. Now go eat.